So you might be asking yourself, who is this girl and why is she giving me advice? Well, my new friend, let me take a moment and introduce myself to you. I, like so many of us, had a really difficult, challenging childhood. The type of childhood that left me wondering if I was lovable, if I was good enough, what will my life be like, how will I be in relationships, will I recognize love, how will I be as a mom, how will I treat myself when I'm older, what kind of relationships will I allow into my life as I grow. I always looked at life on a deeper level. I always felt a little bit different. And I also really found it to be soul level important for me to make sure that the people around me felt loved and that they mattered and that they were included. And eventually one day I realized that I needed to include myself in those values. So I've been on this journey where I've been collecting inspiration through ideas and through material that I've learned and through experiences that I've had and through every person that I've ever worked with on my journey or every friend who shared their story with me. And I realized that there's a part of me that's an educator that wants to share this information, that wants to share my experience and my knowledge that I've obtained throughout my life and spending my life just studying relationships and practicing the skills and tweaking them to make them even work for me even better. And on my journey, I went from being somebody who didn't know if I was lovable, if I could ever really be loved, if I was enough. I was an extreme people pleaser. I was codependent. And now, in my late 30s, I am an empowered woman. I am assertive. I do not settle for relationships that are good enough. They need to be incredible to stay in my life. I have broken the cycle. There is no more abuse in my life. Abuse is not allowed to be a part of my day. And I have an incredible marriage. And I have a son that I absolutely adore and feel beyond grateful that I get to be his mom. So I wanted to create this podcast for you, dear listener, because maybe some of the things that I've experienced or I've learned on my journey is something that you can apply to yours, or you can tweak it and make it your own to fit your journey. So that you can allow yourself and give space for yourself to grow and become who you've always wanted to be, who you're meant to be on that soul level. So not only do I have my own life experiences, I have also spent my life working in the behavioral health field, in the mental health field, and I've also made sure that I have the credentials and the education to fully understand, and I continue to take trainings every year to make sure that I am up to date and that I am continuing to learn and practice the skills that are really truly going to help me create the best relationships that I possibly can have in my life, including and especially the relationship with myself. Through my journey, I learned that the most important relationship I'll ever have is the relationship with me, and I need to start there, and then it just ripples out and influences every other relationship that I have. So I do have a bachelor's in health and human development, a master's in marriage and family therapy. I also have an associate's degree as a wellness practitioner, which means that I also am a certified hypnotist. I'm a certified family life educator. I've studied holistic nutrition and also life coaching. So I've really spent my time studying this area so that I can tie in the research-based skills with the experiences that life has given me as well, so that I can deliver you experts and resources and awesome conversation that will hopefully give you some things to think about and maybe shift your perspective or try out for yourself and see what you like and throw away what you don't, and Anyway, I'm just so honored that you're here to share a piece of your journey with me. And again, I hope that part of my journey can positively influence yours. Welcome to the Beautifully Changed podcast. I'm Steph Perejamas, and I'm delighted you're here. Now, let's make your relationships awesome. Okay, you guys, today I want to talk about love languages and why this is such an incredible tool that's really simple and easy to do and honestly takes 30 minutes or less to give time to on a daily basis. And again, as we go into this, I'm just going to give you a heads up that I am going to suggest that you add a love language into every single day of your relationship. And the reason for that is because we want the consistency to build. And the more consistent you are, the more momentum you have, the more your relationship and the love and the ooey gooey and the connection and the bond and the feeling like you're on the same team just grows and grows and grows. And that, my friend, is an incredible thing. Like when we go into relationships, we want our relationship to be awesome. Can you think of anybody who entered a marriage or a committed relationship and thought, you know what? I just want it to be It could be so-so. I kind of like mediocre. Mediocre relationships are awesome, right? I don't know anybody that genuinely wants a mediocre relationship or feels really fulfilled and loved in a mediocre relationship. So there are many, many things we can do to enhance our relationship, to, you know, make sure that love is flowing in and through and all around our partner and ourselves every single day. And we don't have to make it super complicated. We don't have to make it bigger than it is. It can be these little simple things, right? Like think about, I know this is a go-to analogy that I use a lot, but it's for a reason. Like think about your teeth, right? How long do you spend brushing your teeth? Like it only takes a couple minutes to floss and brush. However, you do that consistently every single day, multiple times a day, right? And because you do that, because you got into the routine, it's part of your day. It's something that you do. You probably have great teeth, right? Like when you go to the dentist, you have a great checkup. You're always like, yay, no cavities, right? You feel really good. And you do this because you give attention to your teeth every single day. So the same goes with your relationship. Give it, you know, your undivided attention every single day. So even though there's lots of tools that you can use and that I like to provide you, today, though, we're going to focus on the love languages as the tool that you can use in your relationship to just boost the love. And I know this can seem like it contradicts a little bit of the message of, well, happiness is an inside job, right? Like we're responsible for our own happiness. Our partner is not responsible for our happiness. So why are we asking them to do this love language thing? And it is true that happiness is an inside job and your partner is not responsible for your happiness, right? You're not responsible for your partner's happiness. They're not responsible for yours. Really, honestly, no one can make you happy anyway because we all experience this world differently. What brings me joy may not bring you joy and vice versa. So happiness really is an inside job. And also loving yourself and knowing that you're lovable and being able to receive love is also an inside job. So then why do the love languages matter? Well, think about how you feel differently around different people, right? Some people, when you're around them, you feel really good. You feel loved and appreciated and that they know you, that they understand you. And then you're around other people and you're like, they don't get me at all. They do not get me. They are clueless. I always feel like invisible when I'm with them. I don't feel included. It just doesn't feel good being around this person, right? Well, which category do you want your partner to fill when they're with you? And which category do you want to fill when you're with your partner, right? You want to fill the good category. You want to feel really good when you're with your person that you are devoting your life to or your time to. You're investing in this relationship and you want it to feel good and you want them to feel good, right? To me, I kind of think about each love language as their own little outfit. You know, like when you put on some outfits, you feel like, I am ready for the world. I am unstoppable. I feel so amazing, right? And then you put on another outfit and you're like, eh, it's okay. You know what I mean? It's nice. I like the color, but it just doesn't fit me quite right. And that's kind of like the love languages. So you want to put on the right outfit for your partner. Or for those of you who are still like, well, I don't know that I really want to put in the extra effort and do the love languages. You know, I don't want to, my partner loves acts of service. Like, really? I have to do more chores now just so that they feel more loved? Like, oh, I don't like doing chores. Why do their love language have to be acts of service? But think about this. So, okay, let's talk about what the five love languages are. They are touch, gifts, words of affirmation, quality time, and acts of service, okay? If you don't know what your love language is or you're curious of what somebody else's love language is, you and your whoever it is you want to find out their love language, you can go to 5lovelanguages.com/quizzes/, okay? And then you will find a quiz there. Take it, know your love language, know the peoples that you care about love language, and use it to your advantage. So think about it like this. When we know somebody's love language and we do that love language, it's like soup, it's like whole food, you know, like that really good nutrition for the soul, for their love, right? For, as Gary calls it, their love tank, right? So when our partner's love language is touch and we make sure that they receive touch, whether that's holding hands, a back massage, you know, a little intimacy. So regardless of what it is, when we do that, it's like we're giving them a really great nutrition-packed meal for their soul and their love tank. However, if their love language is touch and we never do touch or very rarely do touch, but, you know, acts of service is not on their radar at all and we're always doing that, it's almost like you're giving them junk food. Do you know what I mean? It's like, I was hungry. It's better than nothing. Right? But it doesn't really fill them up. They don't feel satisfied after receiving that act of service versus if they received touch. So I think we're good on the metaphors. Okay. I think you get that. Okay. Here is another super duper important thing that I want to say when it comes to love languages. Do not think that your partner is the only one who can do the love language for you. You can also do the love language for yourself. Okay. Go get a massage. Buy your own flowers or your own favorite dessert or one that you just want to try to see if you like. Give yourself appreciation. Like, I'm not ashamed to high five myself, give myself a pat on the back. When I do something awesome, I am going to acknowledge that to myself. And when I also do something just mundane that I just do every day, like cook my food, I'm like, hey, you know what? I made myself a good meal today. That was pretty cool. Good meal. This is tasty. You know what? This meal was so good. I'm going to make sure that when my friend comes and visits me, I'm going to make this for them as well. Okay. Spend time getting to know you. So whatever that is, go for a walk, ask yourself questions, think, read a book, discover what thoughts come up for you, meditate, do some yoga, exercise in a different way, just move your body, go explore the world, explore your life, get to know yourself. And you can also hire help or ask a friend to go and run errands with you. You know what I mean? Like if you want to treat yourself by hiring someone to come and clean your bathrooms, even just one time, do that. Like sometimes I think we forget that there's power in providing ourselves with the love language that speaks to us the most, right? So I think that is really, really important. Fill your own tank and then also make sure you're doing what you can to fill your partner's. So I did want to share with you my sweet friends, I got a gift for you. And I think you are going to love it. And actually, I just think it's really a great idea. And I hope you'll use it. So I made you a calendar that a 1 month calendar that covers all 5 love languages. Now, it is directed more towards her. So I do have a lot of things in there that's like, so full disclosure, I was doing a What Women Want online course that people could buy. And I just had a bunch of like tools and videos, and like it was a whole online course that you could do. And I was like, you know what? Instead of doing a course, I'm just going to give you guys this information for free, because I love just sharing the knowledge that I have with you just in case it's helpful for you, because I know it was super helpful for me. So anyway, I thought, you know what? I'm just going to share this. So anyway, even though it was like the course is designed for the male perspective and for the male to take more action, you as a female can also use this calendar on for your partner and maybe just tweak the ideas so that it's more suitable for him. If the female version is doing the love actions versus the guy. And if you're a guy and you're going to do this calendar for your lady, well then you're welcome. It's already set and ready to go for you. So anyway, if you go to beautifullychanged.com/lovelanguage/, you will be able to download your love language calendar. And I think it would be such a great challenge to give yourself to go download this calendar. And then also, who doesn't love a little to-do list that you get to like check off each item that you do, get that little dopamine hit and feel good, like, hey, I'm making progress on something. Don't even tell your partner you're doing it. Keep it a secret and just go ahead and do this every single day for the next month and see what happens. Like, do it as an experiment. See how different your partner responds to you. You know, just notice what happens when their love tank is filled up. And the reason why I include all 5 is because this way it just makes it simple. You're making sure that no matter what happens, you're hitting the love tank so that they are feeling really great. And then what I think is going to be really cool is you're going to do this. You're going to feel that your relationship just leveled up on the high vibing. And you're hopefully going to want to keep doing this, you know, so you could just keep the calendar and just keep repeating it, or be like, you know what, I noticed that they responded this way when I did this certain day, so I'm going to do more of these days. And you know what, they didn't seem to really care about this day, or they didn't really like it that much, so I'm going to take this day off, or I'm going to put this in instead. Like, you get to have the calendar as your base, as a foundation to just get in the habit of doing a love language every single day. And then you get to create your own calendar, in a sense, based off of what the intel that you're gathering from your partner and doing these love actions and finding out how you can design a day-to-day plan that is really just going to like boost and launch your relationship into this like incredible zone. So I don't know, I'm so excited for you. And I really, truly hope you will use this love language calendar, because I think it is a great idea. I must say, I think it's brilliant. So especially for guys when they're like, I don't really know what I'm supposed to do. Like, can't they just tell me what to do? Because then we're like, well, then it doesn't feel as good because I told you what to do. So now it's not as sincere, right? And then they're like, I don't want to be insincere. Like, I actually want to do things. So as I'm saying this, ladies, what you could do, download it yourself, print it off, give it to him and say, hey, please do this. You know what I mean? You could even, if you see something on the calendar that you're like, I don't really like this idea, or I would want it to be this specific thing, then write that in, like just jot in a little note and then give it to them. But here's the tricky part. After you let go of that paper and you say, hey, please do this, you have to step back and realize they may not do it, or they might not do it perfect. Maybe it takes them 6 months to do this 1 month. Or maybe they only do a couple things. And so this is where it can get tricky, is because if you have the expectation that they're going to do it, you're going to have your hopes up, you're going to feel really excited. And then if they don't do it, you're going to feel super duper disappointed. So you have to make sure that you're doing these things for yourself as well. Do you know what I mean? That way you're not relying on or waiting for your partner to fill your tank, that you are able and capable and willing to fill your own tank so that you can feel amazing. Like, you deserve to feel loved and adored, and you also deserve to treat yourself in a loving and adoring way. And so this goes for if you're single as well. Like, if you are single, do the calendar, but do it for yourself and tweak it. You know, actually, maybe I should make one for singles. That might be a good idea. I'm going to make myself a note of that so that I can do that. You know, because I really would say one of my secrets in life, because I genuinely am a very happy and cheerful person. Like, this is just who I am all day long. You know, I do have grumpy days. Like yesterday, I was kind of grumpy. You know, I worked through it, but I woke up a little bit grumpy. And what I do, like, my secret to my happiness is that I find things that bring me joy every single day. I'm always finding ways to feel good. This was something I did ever since I was like a little girl. I was always finding things that just felt good for me, that made me feel like, I don't know, the world was okay and there was good, and that I could see the silver lining, and that I could be in charge of, you know, some aspects of my life, and how I felt was a part of that. So I was always making sure to do things that felt good for myself. And I still do that to this day. So I'm encouraging you to do the same, because it is so important. And also, it's tempting to not do your partner's love language if you feel like they're not doing yours, right? You're like, well, you're not doing mine, so why should I do yours? With your arms crossed, sigh, an eye roll, all that going on, right? But it really is like, you know, there's this book called Love and Respect, and I really enjoyed it. It is from a Christian perspective, so I don't necessarily agree with every single sentence in the book. However, I do really love the concept of women need to feel that they're loved, and men need to know that they're respected. Not respected like I'm a doormat, but just respected like I admire you. I think you're competent. I think you're capable of doing things. Like, you know, you do a great job. There's a comedian the other day, I was listening to him, and he was like, at the end of every night, his wife would go over what he did wrong that day. So Keone and I have been joking around with that. Like, when we go to bed, I'm like, okay, let's go over all the things you did wrong today. So anyway, I can imagine, and I'm sure you could imagine, that would feel very overwhelming to just hear all the stuff that feels negative, right? We need to hear the good stuff too. So we also need to do the good stuff. So anyway, my whole point is, in the book, he says, if you're not sure who should go first, right? Who should start being the more loving person, showing up in a different way in the relationship? He suggests the more mature partner do that. So whoever who's the most emotionally mature is the one to start this new pattern in your relationship. So maybe you can think about that yourself too. Like, just because they're not doing it on their end doesn't mean that gives you the free pass to not do it on your end. Like, just because it's so easy to not do these things, like, think about how many nights it would be just so easy to skip brushing your teeth and go right to bed, but you still brush your teeth, right? Even if you've had too many drinks, hanging out with your friends, you'll come home, you'll brush your teeth, and you'll go to bed because it was a habit that you've ingrained. It's just part of what you do. And you're going to feel weird if you skip brushing your teeth because your body's like, wait a second, something's off. We didn't do something. What is it? Oh yeah, brush my teeth. Got to get up, brush my teeth. Then I can go to bed and sleep way more peacefully. So that is what being loving like and doing this little extra effort every day, you know, just for your relationship health and enjoyment, would be really great. If like you go to bed at night and you're like, oh crap, I didn't do the little extra effort today, right? So that you notice it. And one of you has to start. And then the other one, once they realize like, oh, this is a new thing, this is our new normal, they'll usually jump on and they'll start doing the love languages as well. You know, sometimes they're just like, I'm not going to get excited about this. What's going to happen is I'm going to do it as well. And then they're going to receive more than I'm going to receive. So you like hold back because you think you're not going to get as much of the love as you're going to be giving. And so I'm just going to ask you to not withhold love, just give it, and then give yourself love as well and be able to receive the love without judgment or the acts of love without judgment, right? Like, oh, they didn't do it good enough, right? Like if they brought you flowers, but not the flowers you like, just bite your tongue, right? And then at some other time when you buy yourself flowers, they can see, oh, and then you can be like, oh yeah, I love wildflowers. Or because some people don't like roses, but if your partner buys you roses, like don't be like, oh, I can't believe you got me roses, right? Because then they're probably less likely to repeat the behavior, right? Because they don't want to get criticized. And so just some things to think about. Anyway, so let's wrap this up. The five love languages again are touch, gifts, words of affirmation, quality time, acts of service. I would also suggest once you understand what your love language is, sit down with your partner and discuss what that means to you. What does quality time actually look like and what does it mean? Does it mean you have to have your TV off, your cell phones down, you're doing an activity together where you're have your all of your attention on each other, you're able to talk, make eye contact, or does quality time also count as, you know, you could be watching a show and I could be reading a book or we could be doing two different things but we're in the same room? What does quality time mean to you? What does touch mean? Now, I'd also say if you are a love language is touch person, give your partner more than just intimate touch, right? Like a massage counts, or when you walk by me and you rub my back, that counts. Holding my hand counts. When we sit on the couch together and you sit next to me and we snuggle up, that counts. Spooning before we fall asleep, that counts. You know, make sure they know all the different ways of touch that counts, because if they feel that only sexual contact is the only touch that counts, then that can feel like, well, how am I ever going to really step up and fulfill that love language as much as they need to? So give them a couple other options so that they can feel like they can be successful in filling your tank when it comes to touch. And when it comes to words of affirmation, if there are specific areas where you like to feel that appreciation a little bit more, or certain things that you want to hear, like whether it's, I don't know, cooking food, or if it's when you get dressed nice, or whatever it is, like where do you feel that you want to hear more appreciation around? Like where is that at for you? Where is it lacking? So that you can let your partner know, like, hey, when it comes to this, I actually really love it when you notice or compliment me or let me know you appreciate when I do this. That feels really good. And also with acts of service, you know, what acts of service mean the most to you and what gifts mean the most to you? So share this kind of stuff with your partner so that you are setting them up to win and to feel like they are successfully filling your love tank up. Well, that wraps up love languages. I hope that you found something beneficial from here. And if anything, go check out the love language calendar that I made for you, because hopefully that will be something that is a tool that you can use starting today. And I really want to hear how it goes for you as well. So if you decide to use the love language calendar, share one of your love and actions with me. Like take a picture of something that you're doing and tag me in it on Instagram so that I can cheer you on, so I can give you love and appreciation and, you know, air high fives. So tag me in it at Beautifully Changed and I would love to cheer you on. So I'm so excited for you to do it. I really am. I just I love it. So anyway, you go out there and you have an awesome day. Love on yourself. Love on your person, and know that I am cheering you on even if I never hear from you. Well, I'm off to go continue working on our backyard, We have finally decided to actually do something besides have it be dirt. So yay for us. I'm really excited to be able to play in our backyard. And so we got the patio almost done. So I'm going to go and help finish that section. And you have an incredible day. I'll talk to you later. Thank you so much for spending some of your time with me today. And make sure to share this episode with someone and leave a review. And remember, you're worthy of incredible love.